Warning: read and follow all labels and the owner's manual. Wrap preheat cover wrap around the air-cooled cable. This does not act as a layer of insulation, but protects from job site and workpiece abrasion. Use a piece of fiberglass tape, or clearly identify the middle of the cable with the wrap on to make the cable wrap process more efficient. If insulation is being used, apply the heating tool over the insulation. This is an example of a typical air-cooled coil on a small diameter pipe using a single heating cable. Start by locating the center of the heating cable. Route the center of the cable over the top of the pipe and pull it through underneath to start the first turn. Route the cable over the top of the pipe again, working toward the joint to start the second turn. If there's enough cable, a third wrap can be added by routing the center of the cable over the top of the pipe again. Once the desired number of turns is applied, route the outer loose ends of the cable through the center loop a few times each, depending on the loop length, to bring the leads together. A typical air-cooled cable induction coil will have 2 to 3 turns on each side of the joint for optimal kilowatt output of the machine. Twist the remainder of the cables together from the coil to the TC extension cable to cancel the magnetic field between them and minimize incidental heating of nearby metal objects. Do not use wire or metal straps to secure cable. Instead, use plastic cable ties, tape, or non-conductive straps to secure cable. Do not hang cable on metal brackets, hangers, or other mechanisms. Stop using equipment if plug, receptacle, or cable is damaged. Replace cable if braid, red jacket, or bare wire is visible. If using TC probes, position them under the insulation under the heating cable in direct contact with the workpiece. To get the joint to weld temperature faster, position the heating cable blanket next to the joint and tight together. To maintain temperature, the coils and insulation can be moved farther from the joint while maintaining temperature for the welding process. Verify you're receiving the best kilowatt output power based on your wrap setup by reviewing the heating parameter screen.